Welcome to the CAD Office Training Guide series for FDOT Connect. I'm Matt Sexton, CAD Application Support Coordinator. Today, I will be going through the FDOT CAD Essentials for Open Roads Designer Connect Edition Training Guide. In this series of videos, I will take you step-by-step through each exercise from the guide. Today, we'll be going over Chapter 7 of the guide. Let's begin. Changing elements. Refining designs usually requires manipulating elements after they have been created. This chapter discusses the manipulation and modification tools provided in Open Roads Designer. Objectives include identifying elements, selecting elements, manipulating elements, modifying elements, and deleting elements. Many times, Open Roads users are not called on to create new designs, but edit existing ones. The users need tools that allow manipulation and modification of existing geometry. Open Roads Designer provides many tools dedicated to changing existing graphic elements. Selecting elements. For operations performed on existing elements within a design file, the user must have the ability to select those elements. This can be done using the Element Selection tool. This tool is located at the far left end of the FDOT tab on the Open Roads Designer ribbon and other logical locations in different workflows on the ribbon. Let's take a look. On the Home tab, the Element Selector is located in the middle of the ribbon. On the Drawing tab, it is also in the middle. On the FDOT tab, it is on the far left. After activating the Element Selection tool, the cursor can be placed over an element, and the element can then be selected by entering a data point. The Element Selection tool allows for the selection of multiple elements to be worked on as a temporary group by a variety of means. Using this method, for example, move, copy, rotate, or scale multiple elements together. By default, selected elements are bracketed with squares called handles. If any elements are selected, an arrowhead icon is displayed in the status bar. The number to the right of the icon is the number of items selected. So, for example, look down here, there's the arrow, the selection set contains four elements. I'd like to go over a few other things about the element selector. You notice that you can expand the tool settings window. You can select everything by a level, color, line style, line weight, all the element attributes you can use to create a selection set right here in this list box. You also have options to select an individual element, select by block, which allows you to draw an area, which you can also do just with the mouse. You can draw a shape. And select using the shape. You can draw a circle as a selection set. And you can strike a line as a selection set. Here, on this row, you'll see new, add, subtract, invert, and clear. What this does is this allows you, with a single click, to select new elements. Every time you click, it selects a new element. It drops the last one from the selection set and adds a new element. If you have it set for add, regardless of what you click, it is being added to the selection set. If you click an element again that you've already selected, it does not deselect it. It is only adding. Subtract only subtracts from your selection set. Even if an element has already been subtracted, it will not add it back to the set. It does not toggle. It is only subtract. The invert setting on the element selection tool allows you to invert the status of an element in the selection set. So, for example, you can add an element to the selection set, and then click it again to remove it. You can continue to add elements to the selection set, and basically toggle them on and off. Clicking in the blank area, entering a data point in the design space, does not cause them to become deselected. Okay. If we're here using the add new only, clicking in the blank space causes them to be deselected. If you have multiple or any elements selected at all, clicking the clear will deselect, and then change the clear button to the select all button. So you can select all and clear. This is where you toggle the handles. You can disable handles when that's highlighted. You won't see the modify handles on elements. Let's go over here. We drew these two lines earlier. You can see they have handles, and now they don't have handles. When you have this select handles button toggled on, you can then select the element by the handle and modify it. Probably not something you'll do very often. And to make the element selection tool settings smaller, you can click the hide extended settings. Let's move on to manipulate elements. The OpenRoads Designer manipulate tools are located on the drawing tab of the OpenRoads modeling workflow. This section contains tools that are used to copy, move, resize, rotate, mirror, and perform other manipulations on elements. These tools can be used in conjunction with the element selection tool to manipulate groups of elements simultaneously. Of course, they can also be used by themselves to manipulate single elements. When you use the element selection tool, an element needs only to be right-clicked to open a menu with the options to copy, move, scale, rotate, mirror, or delete, or display properties. I'll show you that. So you already have access to copy, move, scale, rotate, mirror. This pop up if you right press. Data point is left click. Reset is right click. Right press brings up this context menu. So what do the tools do? Let's take a look. Go to the drawing tab. They're located here. Move element moves an element. Copy element copies an element, makes a copy of an element. Rotate will rotate an element by a number of different methods. Scale will resize an element by a number of different methods. And mirror element will mirror the element, will flip the element by a number of different methods. Let's talk about those. I'm just going to draw some random shapes here, some irregular shapes. I'm going to use, I'd say a random level, but I'm going to use pavement asphalt. So I'm just going to draw a real quick irregular polygon. I'm going to make it fairly irregular so that you can tell when I have rotated or moved it or mirrored it. So I've selected the move tool and notice that it allows me to pick key points. That's because I have my key point snap on. Talk more about snaps in the 2D design. To use the move tool, all I do is I select my key point and then I can move the element. This allows me to say, well, if I want this point to line up with another point somewhere, I can grab this and then snap to that other point or use AccuDraw to move at a specific distance. AccuDraw is down here. Okay. Copy element, also intuitive. You can put in the number of copies you want to make. Works just like move, except suddenly there's another copy. Rotate element, there are three different ways to rotate the element. There's active angle, so I can select, say, 35 degrees, and there's the element rotated. It's rotating based on the point that I snapped on. I can also select rotate about element center, and it'll rotate the element regardless of the point that I snapped on, rotate it about the center of the element. You can also choose to make copies. That will leave the original element and then make a copy of the rotated element. 2 points allows you to select the element and then select a point, and then you can rotate around the point. You can also rotate around element center like that. It's a little weird. And what's happening when I'm not accepting that is I'm hitting the reset button. 3 points. First you select the element, you select the point that it's going to rotate about, and then the point that you're going to rotate from. Notice you have a little bit more control over the rotation than the 2-point rotation. That's the rotate tool. Next, the scaling tool has two options, active scale. So say you want to make something twice as big. There you are. And you can select to make a copy. So in other words, you're copying it and you'll have a bigger copy. The other is by 3 points. So you select the element, you select the point to scale from, and then select the point to scale along. You see you can scale it from that point. That's scaling non-proportionally. You can check the proportional, select the element, select the point to scale from, and now you see it's a proportional scaling. It's more likely you do it that way, at least from my experience. And now the mirror tool. You can select the mirror direction. It can be horizontal, vertical, or according to a line. So vertical mirroring, you select, and then it's, there you are. It mirrored it vertically. Kind of looks like the state of Georgia. You can mirror it horizontally. See, it flips it over. And then by a line. So say you drew a line. First thing you're going to do, select the element and draw the line. And see, as soon as you draw that line across the point you want to mirror it, it flips that element. So let's move on to exercise 7.1. We can use another tool here in the modify section that we haven't talked about yet. Delete. My abstract map of Georgia is now gone. Exercise 7.1, manipulate tools. We're going to cover copy element. So what we're going to do is the first thing is we're going to reference in our survey file. So like we mentioned before, reference files can be attached to your current file so you can see something that's in another file for reference. And since we're attaching the survey file, we're going to use a new tool that we're actually going to discuss in a later chapter. So just work with me on this one. We're going to go to the F.tab and locate the roadway group and select attach survey reference. Okay, now we see that we have the survey file attached. You can use your wheel mouse to pan down to this intersection. Let's go ahead and look and see what we have. We've got some turn arrows, and I'd like to copy those turn arrows. So step three is locate the manipulate tools on the ribbon and select the copy element tool. Let's go back to the drawing tab, locate the copy element tool. Using our wheel mouse, we can pan over. And using the copy element tool, select one of the left turn arrow pavement markings from the left turn lane on the west of the intersection. You'll notice that when I select it, a copy of that element attaches to the cursor. Now we're just going to use our pan to come back over here. And this is where we're going to put it. I realize it's facing the wrong direction. Let's go ahead and put that there. Next, we're going to select the rotate element tool. And what we want to do is we want to select active angle. We want to enter 180 degrees because we want to rotate it 180 degrees about the element center. Then all you have to do is click it. It is not rotating about the element center. Do you know why it's not rotating around the element center? That's because it is a cell, and it is rotating about the cell origin. It's treating the cell origin as the center. So let's try a different technique. Let's do 3 points. So we select the element, select a point, select another point. And we can rotate the element. Not exactly perfect, but then we can use the move tool to move it closer to where we want it. If there are points that you could snap to for specific placement of these cells, you could use those points. Thank you for joining me today for the CAD Office Training Guide series for F.Connect. This was Chapter 7, Changing Elements, from the F.CAD Essentials for OpenRoads Designer Connect Edition Training Guide.